Hello, stream. How are you today? Oh God. Oh. How are you guys? Welcome to a little a very, very late night stream. Well, very late for me anyway. It's like 2 a.m. right now. But I really was like in the mood to stream and I was like, ah, fuck it. Who cares what time it is? Let's play some Pokemon. So yeah, we're playing some hold on. That little smudge in my glasses. I can't see shit. Fucking ridiculous. There we go. Derek, hello, welcome to the stream. By the way, I was literally thinking the same thing. Yeah, last night's stream, Gina started with Gina Picnicker calling us. Like, what the fuck? Our Bulbasaur. Battle Cool. Alright, glad to hear it, Gina. Just, she had to call me at the start of every fucking stream. Jesus Christ. Also, I'm not sure. It's actually a bit dark. Hold on, I just. Oh, let there be light. Is that too bright? That might be too bright. I think that's too bright. Hold on. That's better. I kinda like this better. Oh, that was too white. I mean, I'm fucking, my skin's paling off without it fucking like glowing white from that light being too bright. Anyway, we're playing some more Pokemon Crystal. More of the Wedlock. Last time we ended the stream just as we beat Morty. So now we can. Now we can head over to Olivine City. Okay. Is there anything else we need to do before we head over there though? I don't think there is. I think we're good to go. I already caught something over here which I think was a Meowth. I think. Pretty sure it was a Meowth. So we caught a Meowth. Yeah. Alright, I think we're good to go. We can just go over here and fight all the trainers and get ourselves to Olivine City. I'm gonna wait till I get the good rod before I start going to towns and like, well, I'm gonna wait. I think I'm gonna wait till I get, I have fly and I have the good rod before I decide to start going to towns to try and catch water Pokemon, because now we have surf. Because I'm like, oh, I might as well wait till I have the good rod as well, so that I can like look and see what water Pokemon are available, whether I fish or surf, and then I can decide, oh, which ones are better. I'll go for that one. And obviously it would be good to wait till we have fly, which we'll get over here as well, because then we can fly to all the towns and do all of it, all that shit at once. Like, we can fly to Violet, well, we don't have to fly to Violet City, but we can fly to Violet City, we can go to Cherry Grove City, and we can go to New Parktown and get all these water Pokemon that we're that we can capture. We also have to make sure to try and get to what do you call it, the unknown place, the unknown ruins, so that we can get ourselves a Quagsire finally. I'm hoping they actually show up during the night, because if it's not, if they're only there during the daytime, that's going to be bad. Hello, Pineapple 323. Welcome to the stream. I've not seen you in a little while, man. How's it going? The Ruins Valve. That's the place that I forget the name of all the time. And the Unknown Ruins, Ruins of Isle, fucking same deal. And before Xatu. Yeah. I just gotta make sure I don't go through the I think if you go through the Union Cave, you can end up in a different part of the Ruins of Isle where there are Natus there. But that is not where we want to go, because I really don't want a Natu. I mean, I wouldn't mind a Xatu. It would be an interesting Pokemon to have. But I don't think it's very good. It's kind of bullshit though, because like, I think Will has two Zatus in his team, which are like level 40 and 42, and they both have Psychic, but I don't think it actually learns Psychic until like level 50 or some shit. So Will's either A, cheating scum, or B, somehow has two Psychic TMs. So God knows what happens with that. Okay, if we beat this girl, we'll get her phone number, and then she will give us, or she will find, Thunderstones for us. And, oh shit, I just remembered, I totally forgot to get the phone number for the kid that finds Firestones for you. I should probably do that. And then there's the guy that gives you Waterstones, which is just east of Mahogany Town. I could probably go over there and get that done as well. Because the sooner we get the phone numbers, the sooner they will potentially find those stones for us, which we may need. You never know if we're going to end up having a fucking Weeping Bell, or a Gloom, or a Staryu, or a fucking Vulpix, or any shit like that in our team that we would actually need an Evolution Stone for, so it's better to get it out of the way early. The AI do always cheat, like they have fucking, especially in this game, like there's so many Pokemon that you've come across that are like not fully evolved, or that are fully evolved when they shouldn't be, and there's fucking, by the way, Lance is cheating as well. He has a fucking Aerodactyl with Rock Slide. It's impossible to get an Aerodactyl with Rock Slide in this game, yet he has one. And I think Machamp, I think Koga's Machamp is the same. I think that thing has got Rock Slide, but I don't think there's any way to actually give a Machamp Rock Slide in this game. So, fucking cheating bastards. It's bullshit. Did I forget to talk to her to get her phone number, by the way? I think I just did. I'm a smart man. I'm too busy ranting about fucking AI cheating. Hello. Not Koga, fucking Bruno. My bad. I meant Bruno. I don't know why I said Koga. It's fucking dumb. I was planning to start the stream a little bit earlier, by the way. Like, I was going to stream like an hour ago or something. But then I was like, God, I'm so hungry. And I'm like, I'm going to make some ramen. So I went and cooked some ramen noodles, and I just sat and ate that. So that's why it took me, that's why, I think I said to you, Derek, in chat and Discord a while ago, saying I was thinking about streaming, and this is me just getting into it, because I was busy eating. Well, we finally made it here, so no biggie. My god, this Corsair is going to be so annoying. Yeah, I went onto Twitch because of that new Twitch Prime thing that they announced, and I was kind of like looking at that, and then I went to my channel and stuff, and then I saw you. Yeah, I saw your message. This fucking Corsola, are you serious with this bullshit? Is this thing seriously just gonna spam fucking? Oh my god. That's gonna. Oh my god. Don't recover. Oh, you piece of shit. This fucking Corsola is taking the piss. Don't you recover? Thank you. Really need to get Raticate or Arlanda some better moves that aren't normal type or flying type. This team has no way of dealing with rock type Pokemon. It's kinda ridiculous. I don't know if either of them can even get any moves to hurt rock types though. I know, I'm pretty sure Arlanda can't. I think Mud Slap's like the best thing we can get for Arlanda to like hurt rock types with. Raticate, maybe, I think he can learn like Surf and Ice Beam and shit like that, but god damn, that fucking Corsola. That Corsola was fucking ridiculous. It just would not die.
Ba, 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 ba.
So yeah, TwitchCon is actually going on right now. My immediate thought was when I remembered that TwitchCon was going on right now, I was like, yes, nobody will be streaming. I'll get all the viewers. If only. But I mean, I'm going to be streaming a bunch this weekend anyway. We're going to be doing the Golf With Your Friends stream tomorrow, and then I'll probably play a bit more Time Splitters after we play that for a little while, and then Sunday I'll probably stream some more as well. I'm not sure what I want to play on Sunday. I'll definitely be doing probably more Time Splitters on Sunday, but I don't know what else. So that'll be a thing that I'm gonna have to deal with at some point. But tonight I was just like, yeah, I just want to play some Pokemon. Late night Pokemon chill kind of stream. Well, I mean, hopefully it'll be chill. That is a Nuzlocke we're playing, so I just gotta hope that nobody dies that makes me fucking rage at 2 a.m. Nope, did not mean to do that. Nope. Oh yeah, there's Miltanks here. There's a nugget there as well. Don't you have to feed this thing like 10 berries or some shit? And then it'll like heal and then you can get Moo Moo Milk here. But I think, I don't know how to really farm berries in this game. I've never done this, but I've never actually bothered doing that before. I always just leave that the milk tank to just be sick for the whole game. Because there's no berry farming in this game. Like, there's no way to like farm berries, and I never bother going around all the trees that are around the region to like pick up more. I'm just like, meh, fuck it. This could be a problem, especially since I don't have any Mudslaps left. Probably should switch. Although I'm assuming this Pikachu will only have Thundershock at this point. I don't think it will have Thunderbolt at all. I don't think it gets that until like level 26, so we may have been okay, but better to do to be safe. To be safe than sorry. Also, I think this is isn't this technically a different route down here? We can maybe, I think it is. We can maybe catch something else on the grass over there. I can't remember what you can actually catch over there though. Why do you all have Pikachus? Alright, let's just see if our lander can fucking. A couple of Swifts should be able to take this thing out pretty easily. Oh, or just the one. Cool. Da-da. Oh yeah, there's that woman in there that we can fight as well. Yeah, I remember. Yeah, Chuck. I know Chuck's highest level is 30. Jasmine's is 35, and I think Price's is 32. And this, I think. And then Claire is 40. Yeah, I think I remember all the highest levels of the rest of the gym leaders that we have left. I think getting to 30 shouldn't be too bad. Well, I think training for Chuck won't be too bad. There's a ton of trainers between here and his gym that we can fight. And if we need to train at all, training in the ocean against Tentacles and Tentacruels is actually a really good way of training. They actually give really good XP. So hopefully we won't have to spend too much time training if we need to. Also, yeah, look at that. Rack 8 level 17. Doesn't actually have up to level 20, bitches! Price is that really? Is Price, is he really 31? That low? How is he that low? He's supposed to be the 7th gym leader, and he's 4 levels under the 5th gym leader, and 9 levels under the 8th. Like, what the fuck? Makes no sense. The way they did the levels in the gyms in this game is just so fucking weird. Like, they clearly should have switched the levels between Jasmine and Price. I don't know, I don't understand why they two are like the way they are. They should definitely, they should be flipped. I don't know why the hell they're. It's just weird. I mean, I guess you could just ignore Jasmine and go fight Price first, and then do Jasmine. But it's not weird. It's not very strange. Alright. Alright, we'll fight her and then we'll try and catch... Well, I still have to... I'm trying to figure out if this is a different route. I'm pretty sure it is, but I can look at the map real quick. Just to be sure. Yeah, you can fight any- yeah, the Chuck, Jasmine, and Price, you can pretty much fight in any order. As long as you do all the stuff before the gyms, you can like go- you can like get- you can get all the way up to Price without fighting Jasmine or Chuck. Which is pretty ridiculous, because you could just do all that and then just fight like three gym leaders in a row, which would be quite weird. It's very strange. Why do you have a berry? Yeah, that's 38 and that's 39 that I'm on right now. Yeah, okay. We can catch something else here then. Let's see what we find! Hopefully something interesting. I'm not sure what you can catch here at night though. If anything wants to actually appear, that is. I forgot, I did not register my bike yet. Maybe I should... Well, I mean, I don't really need the bike. If I need to go fast, I can just fucking do that shit. Oh, hello. Well, I already have a Meowth, so I don't really need to catch you. Thank you though. Can I fight something else, game? Another Meowth. Is that all that's here? Is it really only Meowth here? There must be something else. What the fuck? Why is it just Meowths? Raticate? I already have a Raticate. Is there only Pokemon here that I've caught already? What the fuck? Have I caught a Hoothoot? I can't remember if I've caught a Hoothoot or not. I know I don't have a Noctowl because the Pokeball's not there, but I don't know if I've caught a Hoothoot or not. I don't think I have. I mean, I guess I could catch it and then go check. And if I have already caught one, then I can just release this and then just look for something else here. God. Noctowl, why do you have such ridiculous special defense? Nice. See, it sucks because like I'm always playing this at night. Like I'm always streaming this at night, so I only catch Pokemon that show up at night. I feel like I'm missing out on a lot of good Pokemon just because I don't play this during the day at all. I guess maybe from now on, if I'm gonna set the time in these. If I'm going to set the time in any games that have a day and night cycle, maybe I should like change them a little bit. It's fucking shit getting... I don't know what's happening. Something happening upstairs. Why the fuck is this thing not getting caught? I think my tackle did about as much as confusion did. Oh my fucking god. Noctowl's taking the piss. Would you just get caught? There we go. Fucking Noctowl. God damn. The fact that this thing is like 5'3" and only weighs 90 pounds, that's pretty ridiculous. You'd think a Noctowl, you'd think something that big would weigh more. Also 5'3"? God damn, they really had his height, like, they really made him a lot smaller in the anime, didn't they? Oh shit, oh yeah, I have to think of a name for a Noctowl. Where are there owls? What's an owly place? Is there any place known for like having owls in it? To the internet. Could I look up like Owl Sanctuary or something? Just go to Google Maps and search Owl Sanctuary and just see what places show up and then just pick one that fits, I think. Probably a good way of going with it. The Screech Owl Sanctuary. What the hell is that? What the hell is that? Oh, it's down in England. Okay, let's go with that. That'll fit. Hold on. Phone. Alright. We'll call you Victoria. There's an owl sanctuary in Victoria, plus Victoria is also a girl's name. So there we go. Saw an article about a guy in France who went into an Apple store and smashed all the iPhones. Jesus Christ. What the fuck? Was that like, I guess that was recent. Maybe he was just really angry about the headphone jack. Like, what the fuck? That's really weird though. I can never understand people that do shit like that. Like, did they go in thinking, yeah, I can just do this and it'll be fine? Like, that happened, it was today? Jesus Christ. Guy's got some fucking issues to work out. Alright, let's have a look at the PC. Can I? Oh, I can still look at stuff. Okay, so I have... We have... Noctowl, Meowth, Coughing, Spinarak, Psyduck, Drowsy, Apom, Speedo, Venonat, Zubat, Ekans, Egg, Vegas. Okay, so we didn't have a hoot yet. What a hoot. Imagine how much money he destroyed. Yeah, fucking Christ. That is crazy. I can't believe somebody would just go and do that. Like, is there any power of the thought? Like, yeah, I'm gonna get away with this. This seems so weird. Like, I wonder, like, did he go in with, like, a mask and like hold the place up and start smashing them, or did he just like walk in casual wear and just start smashing shit? Like, what the fuck? Also, why the fuck does the Apple why does the Apple store have them? Do they not have them in like locked cases or something, so people couldn't just go in and do that? Like, I imagine they're all at least tethered to something, so you can't just grab it and like throw it on the ground. I imagine he must have went in with an actual like weapon and like started like beating the shit out of them. It's fucked up, man. It's fucked up. I love how the frame rate just goes to shit every time I walk into a door. It's awesome. Also, where the hell is the guy that gives you the fucking? Oh, he must be in this house. Oh, hello. Sure. I mean, I literally just got your number like 10 minutes ago, but sure, I'll come fight you. Hey, thank you. He had like a metal ball. It's weird. Oh, we still have Shadow Ball. Could still give that to somebody. I still have the old rod, actually. I forgot that I even picked that up. But I guess, like, it's a bit hard to use that because you only really get Magikarps for it. So. Oops, sorry. Did not mean to do that. Well, I guess we might as well go fight Dana Lass. Also, in fact, while I'm over here, I'm going to go talk to the schoolboy that gives you fire stones, and I'm going to go fight the guy that gives you water stones as well, real quick, just so we can get their numbers as soon as possible. Hello, Dana. Let's fucking go! I mean, it's only been like 10 minutes. I don't know how you thought you got strong enough to now beat me. I mean, I'm pretty sure you're the exact same level, actually, that you were on. Although, that Flaffy kinda scares me. So I'm just gonna put you to sleep. God, Mexico, you really need to get some better moves. I don't know if there's any other better moves that I can even give you, though. Like, I know I can learn Psychic, but we need a TM for that. And you don't get that until post-game. I don't know what other moves Butterfree even learns. Well, Dana, it was fun, but, well, thanks for the 3 XP, basically. See ya. Alright, I think it's Alan's schoolboy, and I'm pretty sure it's the one that's in the national park, I think, is the one that gives you firestones. It's either the one in the national park, or it's this guy. Stuff I got is day 2, there's more to learning than just reading books, reading and working, I have. Oh yeah, it's this guy. It's this one. I think the one that's in the park just like wants to battle you. Alright. It's fucking Psybeam at 30. Jesus Christ. I did not want to do that. Gust at 28, Psybeam at 34. I mean, they're not great moves for when you get to those levels, are they? I mean, those are the kind of moves Gust and Psybeam would be the kind of moves I would expect it to have, like, now. Not fucking at those levels. Alright, I would quite like to get across here without a Pokemon in the water showing up. Because I know for a fact that the Pokemon that show up in this route when you're surfing are Goldeen and Seaking, and they're the only ones. And I don't really want to catch one of those. I would rather catch something over here in the long grass. That's over on this side. Also, I might as well just walk all the way over here actually and just get to Mahogany Town. That way I can just fly over here where later on when I need to come this way. Alright. Yeah, this guy. Fight this guy and talk to him and he'll find you some water stones. Oh, Quillfish. You're one of those few Pokemon that people just kind of forget exists sometimes. Really? You just had to poison me. Fisher Tully. Why is his sprite, like, not all the way in? It's kind of weird how he's just, like, half out. The fuck? Does the fisherman sprite always do that? Or was that just a weird glitch? Yay. Alright, now we got every person that gives you Evolution Stone's number and Joey as well, because, I mean, you just have to have Joey's number. Okay, I'm pretty sure this guy has a Nidoran, male and female? Or a Nidorino and a Nidorina? And then the other guy I think has Diglett and Dugtrios. I'm pretty sure, if I remember correctly. The one time I used Tackle and it fucking misses. I like how that was a critical hit, but it still only did one damage, by the way. Like, what the fuck? Oh, that's something I have to remember to do on Sunday. Is come on here and try and get the TM for Return. Maybe not Nidorino, but doesn't Nidorino have Peck? Why the hell would it not use it? I mean, I'm pretty sure it has Peck by that level, surely. Whatever. Alright, what do you got? Pretty sure this guy has Diglett's. I'm not sure if it's Diglett and Dugtrio, but I know he has at least one Diglett, I think. Possibly two? He might have a Dugtrio as well, actually. Oh, okay, maybe not. Maybe it's two Diglett's and a Geodude. Also, actually, I'm kind of... Probably should switch, actually. This thing may have... Rock Throw. Yep. Diglett-Dig, Diglett-Dig, Trio, Trio, Trio. Diglett-Dig, Diglett-Dig, Trio, Trio, Trio. God, when that episode first aired back when I was a kid, me and my friends literally... Just all day... All day, every day, we would just sit and sing that. Just diggly dig, diggly dig, trio, trio, trio. I think my parents wanted to fucking rip my fucking voice box out of my throat just because of how much I did it. I mean, it's a fucking trio. Huh. What do you know? Benjamin. Alright. Mahogany Town. I mean, if I wanted to, I could just go up and catch fucking the Red Gyarados right now. I'm not really interested in doing that, though, when all of my team aren't even, like, past level 25 yet. That fucking... I assume that that Gyarados will probably destroy, like, my whole team if I tried to go up there and fight it right now. Alright, let's see what we can catch in here. Zubat, I already have one of you, so you can fuck off. Really? Why is there so many Pokemon? I feel like the Pokemon you get at night are so, like, I feel like it's very slim pickings at night time. Because we just keep getting the same shit. Every route is just the same shit that I've already caught. Like, what the fuck? Really? Is there really nothing else here that I can catch? Am I gonna have to just catch something in the water? Because it looks like that's the case. Oh, there we go. I'll take a fucking model. It's better than nothing. It's better than a Pokemon that I already have. That's for goddamn sure. I of course will name it Marland after the state, and also obviously after Marland, the fucking YouTuber who I love, and I know you love Derek obviously because you are a Patreon just like I am, Hafiz. Although this thing does not want to get caught. I don't really want to tackle it though, just in case. Oh, I have a lure ball. That's for hook Pokemon though, actually. That's not going to work any better. Hey, there you go. Big service. Meow meow. I hope that's fits. Is it what? Just the one? Is it just the one R for Maryland? That just looks like Maryland. I'm gonna make sure I get the spelling for this right. Okay, yeah, that's right. Do you know what else is a great thing? That's named after Maryland. Well, not named after Maryland, not the YouTuber anyway. But a great thing that also has the name Maryland are these cookies that I always buy. They're fucking awesome. Pretty good cookies, and they're called Maryland cookies. And they're pretty goddamn good. Okay, so now that we got all that shit out of the way, I can heal myself up. And then, I think the only thing next for us to do is to go up the lighthouse, I think. I don't know why I'm healing it. I don't know why I needed to heal there again. I absorbed it full HP, but what the fuck ever. Alright. Actually, just thinking about this, I haven't caught anything in Olivine City yet, but I think, I'm pretty sure, if you use the good rod down here, I think you can get Cloisters, Shellders, and Chinchows. I'm pretty sure. And I don't think it matters what time of day it is, So let's see if we can catch one of those. That would be pretty interesting, getting a cloister or a lantern. We're gonna have a shit ton of water Pokemon to use in this playthrough. Or we could just get a fucking Tentacool, that's awesome. Probably should have went out and caught one of these in the ocean first before I came in here. Oh well. Quite disappointed. Not gonna lie. Quite disappointed that my encounter down here is a goddamn Tentacool. Might as well lure ball him. Boom. Wait, I already have something called Tokyo. I was literally about to call it Tokyo. And I already have one called Tokyo. What's another city in Japan? I can't. The only two I can think of now is fucking Nagasaki. And what's the other one? Hiroshima. There's only two coming to mind now, which is a horrible thing. I can't think of any more Japanese cities other than Tokyo and those two. Kyoto, thank you, that's fucking... I knew there was a K one that I was just forgetting that was so obvious. Kyoto. Because hentai, of course. Anyway. Alright, just... okay, hold on, I just want to, like, make sure I'm not crazy. Like, you can catch... Yeah, you can get shelters and shit here. God damn it. Well, fuck. That was a waste of an encounter, kind of. Because there's like a million of them in the ocean that we could have caught. Ah, well. That's just the breaks, I guess. Alright. Let's go up the lighthouse. Do you know what this guy has? A Noctowl. Gentleman Alfred. You know, do you think it would have been funnier for them to give him a Golbat? Because his name's Alfred. were the walls always that god-awful colour? They sure were. Yeah. A fucking moss green. For some reason. I don't know why the hell they made the inside of the lighthouse look like this. It just looks really weird. God, I wish I had Rock Throw right now. Okay, I'm just gonna fucking... There we go. Just speed up the whole sleeping thing. Yeah. Excuse me. Probably should thrash out. I was just thinking there as well, actually. I don't know if I want to get a Politoed in this, because I think you only get one King's Rock in this game, although I'm not sure if they consume the item when they evolve with it, because usually you're supposed to trade with it, but I did turn on, I did use the randomizer to turn on the thing that changes impossible evolutions in ROMs, like trade evolutions for example. So I think I would just have to give a Slowpoke or a Poliwhirl the King's Rock and it would evolve them, but I'm not sure if they would consume it. I don't know if I would want to get a Politoed or a Slowking. I guess Politoed, because I think Politoed's a lot better than Poliwrath, but Slowking and Slowbro are both pretty good. Although to be fair, I haven't actually run into a Slowpoke yet that I could catch, but I think when you go in the cave that you have to use Waterfall on and the and Victory Road, I think the only thing that really appears in there are Slowpokes. So I'll probably end up catching one there. But I'll probably just turn that one into a Slowbro if I ever used it, and then just use the King's Rock for a Politoed if I ever want to do that. I'm just thinking out loud here, don't mind me. Gina, what do you got for me? Practice. Oh my god. Maybe later, Gina. I'm fucking busy right now. I'll come fight you when after I get fly. I would like to try and get Onyx as much XP as possible here, because we're not going to be able to use him like at all, and we're not going to be able to use him like at all for the next like little while, because he's weak to all the trainers in the ocean, he's weak to all the fighting Pokemon, and he's weak against all the steel Pokemon, and he's weak against the ice gym. So like, I would like to try and get him as much XP as possible from any trainer that he can actually fight. Unless, of course, like, I guess when I'm fighting the trainers in the water, I could always just switch from Onyx into Butterfree with all the trainers, but that's going to be annoying to deal with. Having to constantly switch and Butterfree having to take free hits every single battle. Especially considering Butterfree doesn't exactly have great defences. Okay, this guy has like fucking 20 million Pidgeys, so I'm just going to speed this up. Because god fucking damn it, dude. Why the hell do you have so many goddamn Pidgeys? Also, I'm running out of Headbutt PP. Hey, a girl with something that Onyx can actually fight. How fucking nice. See ya. I think we can check that out later. When we're coming back down. Oh, hello. Just gonna switch. Oh god, hello. God, there's so many stupid sailors in here that have polybuttles. And polywags. And all that shit. Okay, I think there's only this guy left. And I think that's it. Oh, hello, Machop. Oh, you have low kick. That could actually be quite bad for me. Oh god, ow. Yeah, that did. Well, I mean, I could finish off with a dig. No problem. And another Machop. Let me switch. Also, let me heal, because Mexico's a little bit too low. Okay. Nope. I think there's a... Oh, yeah, there is. I was going to say, I think there's a item in here that I can grab before I leave. Okay. Okay, that's the kind of thing I'm looking to fight. Some nice little Spearows that I can just beat the shit out of. Oh, and a Fero. Hello. God, why is Rock Smash so shit? Alright, I think you two are done for now. Let's get York and Arlanda out here. Nope, nope. There we go. TM34, which I can't remember what that is actually. And a rare candy. Well, actually, what is TM34? Oh, Swagger. I don't know if I want to use Swagger on anybody. I mean, it could be actually a useful kind of move to use against any, like, special Pokemon or special attacking Pokemon that we may have some trouble with, but I can't think of who I would actually want to even put that on. Hmm. Okay, I think that's us done for here. Okay. Okay. Oh, do you know what I guess I could do now? I actually got the strength HM, and I never actually gave it to anybody. Just want to check out what that's all about. See who can learn it. York, Wyoming, Sydney, and Rome. I guess York's probably the best option for it. Well, no, maybe not. I would actually be fine giving this to all of them. Like, Wyoming, Rome, and York, I would be totally fine giving that to either of these guys. Because they both, especially Rome and York, like, both have a couple of basically free moves that I don't use that I could easily take over with, and both could use. Yeah, but I think I'll just give it to Rome for now. I'm just going to put it over Rock Smash, because Rock Smash is fucking terrible. It's so bad. It's not even worth using. I mean, I could give it to York as well. That way he has, like, a stronger, like, normal-type move that isn't hyper, that's not, like, inaccurate. As inaccurate as Hyper Fang. And I never use Tail Whip. And I mean, if I ever get to a point where I desperately need one more move slot for him, I can always go to Blackthorn and get rid of that, because I doubt he's gonna learn a ton of moves between now and then that I'm gonna be like, oh, I don't know what I could take away, because he just has too many good moves. I don't think that's gonna be an issue, so let's just do that. Anything else I want to do before I head to Cedarwood Island? I don't think there is. Oh, do you know what I could do? Since I already have a Tentacool, and I think the only Pokemon that you can really get... I guess I could have a look, actually. Since I'm on this route right now, rather than, like... I could use the rod to see if I can find anything other than Tentacool in the water, since I already have them, but I could also, what I could do is I could smash these rocks to see if I can find anything in these. What route is this, actually? Oh, it would help if I didn't speed it up. Route 40. Let me just look some stuff up. Johto Route 40. What have we got? Oh, Okay, so fishing. You can get crabbies, you can get Magikarps. Okay, no, okay. Well, that's for the old one. For the good rod, you can get Magikarps. You can get Staryus at night. You can also get Magikarps with the good rod and Corsolas, although they're not at nighttime. And then in the rocks, you can get Crabbies or Shuckles. You can get Shuckles from the rocks, but it's only a 10% chance, so it's probably not going to happen. So I could either try and get a Staryu, which is only a 10% chance, or I could get a Krabby. But which do I want to go for? I mean, the Staryu would probably be pretty cool. Having a Staryu would be awesome. Because I think this is like one of the only places that you can even get Staryus. But I don't want to accidentally run into a Magikarp and have that be my encounter, because then I can't catch the shiny red one, because I'd already have one. Also, fuck. I also just got rid of Rock Smash, so I can't even fucking... I literally can't even smash these rocks, even if I wanted to. Also, I guess if Magikarp does show up, I can just kill it. I mean, it's not a huge loss missing out on an encounter for this route, considering it's just another water type and we're going to have a fucking million water types to use. So, screw it. Let's just see if we can try and get either a Krabby or a Staryu. Anything but the Magikarp, please. Staryu would be awesome. Staryu? Ah, of course not. Had to be the Magikarp. And I'm just going to run away. Ah well, it was worth a try. I also forgot about this up here. Hello. Is there anything you can actually do in here? Like, is there any prize? Oh god. This is the battle tower. I think you can do it any time as well. It just goes up to like the next level. Like, you can only do it when you're on... Like, if you go in there, like, if I go in there, then I'd have to fight Pokemon that were on level 30. And if I was on level 31, I would have to fight stuff that's on 40. So you have to, like, be on the 10th level. Also, you can headbutt trees here. Is there anything you can actually... Is this a different route? This is route 40. Is this a, like, different route when you go up here? Yeah, battle tower. Can I actually catch something here? Can I, like, headbutt these trees and catch something? Might as well see. It's technically a different area. It's possible that there might not be any Pokemon that appear in these trees though. It's looking like there's probably nothing here. Alright, well. But yeah, I don't think there's actually any like prizes or anything you can even get from here, from like winning battles. Which is kind of dumb. Doesn't do anything. Hello. Yeah, I remember this battle tower being fucking brutal as well. What does this do? Does this just tell you, like, sure, Pokemon may enter, all must be different, the items they hold also must be different, certain Pokemon may also have level restricted places on them. That's just a PC. What do you say? Battle tower welcomes you, I could show you to a battle room, would you? Challenge. So yeah, I think this is just like a challenge thing for fun. You don't actually get any prizes or anything from it, which is kind of weird. You'd think they would have had something there for you to, like, possibly get with battle points, but I don't think battle points were even a thing that existed yet. Okay, oh, first things first. Before I go into this route, I need to buy repels, because fuck not having repels on the ocean. That is something I do not want to have to deal with. Also, I can sell this nugget. I got. I can sell that awakening as well, don't really need that anymore. And I can sell these super potions since I have those thingies. Is there anything else I have that I can sell? I sell that HP, I'm sure. Nah, that's everything. Okay. Some super repels, please. I'm about like By 25. There we go. Nope. Let me just stick these right at the top so that I can just get access to them immediately as well. Nope. What actual route is this? Just trying to think. That's route. So we've got. This whole route's 40, really? And then it's 41 down there, and then it's seen what's it. Okay. God, look at this really awesomely detailed map. Okay. Let's go! I'm searching the ocean. Might as well put the repels on there now since I don't actually have any encounter on this route since I already tried to catch something. And it was just a madcap! I guess I could look on Route 41 as well, actually, because I could. Well, in fact, I don't actually know if I can. I can't fish while I'm on the water in this game, but I can. I think I can surf on Route 41 from Scenewood Island. I'm pretty sure. What can you get here? You can get mantines as well, which I could look for, which would take a while because they're only a 10% chance. You can get. Oh, that's a super road. You can still get star you for 10% chance of getting a star you. 60% chance of getting a crabby. I don't know. Maybe we'll just leave it for now. I mean, I guess I could wait till I catch the shiny Gyarados, and then whenever I go fishing, I don't have to worry about having to deal with a shitty Magikarp, and I'm like, I already have a Gyarados, so I can't catch you, Magikarp. Go fuck yourself. And I can actually look for something better. Okay. Well, there's like a million trainers on this route as well. It's going to be a pain in the arse trying to navigate this whole area so that I can actually try and fight them all. Hey, look, that's the thing I was trying to find. I think you can actually find. I think if you use the good rod in the daycare center, because there's like a little pond that you can go into in the daycare center. I think if you use a good rod there, you can get star use as well. But I've already caught something on that route, so I would not be able to go and do that, unfortunately. Oh well. Them's the breaks. Thank you. You know, I was just thinking actually. I don't actually know how strong is. Oh, that's not how you do it. Move. Hyperfang, really? Is Hyperfang only 80? I guess the other thing is that they could cause flinching. But strength's probably better to use more often, since it's the same power. And strength's 100% accurate. I think Hyperfang is only like 90 or 85 or something. Alright. God, the game looks like it has such a weird frame rate because of just because of how shitty the water is animated in this game. It like moves at like 2 frames. More shelter. God, all the trainers here are just rubbing in that I didn't get a shelter and I didn't get a star you and I was looking for them. War Turtle. I want to at least try and get Rome some XP, so I'm going to send him out first and then just switch between him and Mexico and hope that works. If that doesn't work out, like if they keep getting... I mean that's the thing, like Sydney and Wyoming aren't exactly a good pair for this because Wyoming is obviously weak to water and Sydney doesn't really have many moves to hurt water types, so this is going to be a bit of a ordeal dealing with this whole route, I think. We don't really have a lot of Pokemon that are good for fighting water types. Thank God this is the only route in the game, really, where you have to fight a lot of water types. Otherwise, I'd be fucked. Okay, I'm gonna switch to Mexico. Oh, this thing has a Rota Beam as well, that's really annoying. I mean, it's not doing a lot of damage, but that's still super effective and it lowers my speed, which could be bad. Okay, well, that's not very good. I mean, Tentacles are fine though, I can always just switch to Mexico and then just a couple of confusions deals with them pretty quickly. Oh, a Tentacruel, oh god, a Tentacruel, that could actually be quite bad. This thing's yep. I was gonna say, it probably has like Acid and Bubble Beam and shit, and that's gonna probably do a lot of damage. I think I said probably way too many things there. Okay. Ooh, Crack Light, nice. Don't you poison me. Holy shit. Okay. Oh god, let's try and switch to Sydney. Does he even have, does he have anything to deal with them? There's Bite, I guess, and Cut, which aren't too bad for this kind of point in the game, so hopefully he'll be okay. I'll just probably use Sydney for a little while and then maybe switch back to Orlando and York for the rest of the route, because the rest of the team are just not good. They can't deal with all the fucking war types. It ain't gonna happen. God, the Seeking's actually doing quite a lot of damage. Yeah, we're fine. Nope. We got all these lemonades, so we're good. Already insane would say. Oh shit. Ah, really? Repair lasted a lot longer than I thought it would. I guess maybe while, oh god, while I'm here, I can jump into the Pokemon Center and get healed up. And then jump back out. Okay. Yeah, we still got a bunch of trainers around the Waddle Islands to fight, so. Excuse me. I'm pretty sure I remember there's a guy on this route as well that has like two Gyarados, which is fucking ridiculous. Some random guy just like, hey, I got a Gyarados. Alright. Like, relax. And there's no need to have a fucking Gyarados, man. Especially two, like, the hell, man. Nope. So I fucking... It's hard to tell where the hell you're going when you're trying to use this speed up thing to move around. Just all of a sudden you're on the other side of the goddamn planet and you're like, oh, where am I? Hello. What do you have? Hey, more star use. Just rub it in even more, game. Oh, and a Starmie. Damn! Where the hell did you get a Waterstone from? I like how you have a Starmie, but the only moves you decide to use are fucking Tackle and Rapid Spin. Good choice. Good waste of a really strong Pokemon there, you dumb bitch. Okay, is there anything up from ya? Oh, did I fight you already? I did not! You're sketchy. Alright. Oh god, why do you have six Pokemon? Jesus Christ. Okay, well this is gonna be... It's gonna... speed through this as fast as possible. Because holy shit. Oh, Remoraid. I was not expecting that, of all things. I fought you though, didn't I? Yeah, I did, okay. Let me go back down here. I think the only ones left are the ones that are kind of around the middle area. Like one here, there's like one. I think there's a few, like two or three more after this guy, and that's it. And then we can get to Seamwood Island. Thank God. Swimmer Kirk. Ah, this is the guy with the Gyarados. Hello. Probably should have switched, actually. Now that I think about it. Oh my fucking god. Did that thing. Do these things have fucking... either that thing had Dragon Rage. Oh, in fact, no, don't they have Thrash when they fucking evolve? That could be pretty bad. Please don't... Oh, thank god, I think it just used Bite on there. Jesus Christ. That was fucking terrifying. All of a sudden, Arlanda went from having, like, full HP to, like, 14. Jesus fucking Christ. That was scary. That. Just heal her up just in case something happens. Okay, I think I fought you already. Yeah. Nope. Haven't fought you yet though. You have a, oh, another Quillfish. The forgotten Pokemon. I think you're possibly the last trainer that I have to fight. I don't know if there's maybe one more. Okay, no. Not up there. Maybe one, oh god. Maybe one more over here, but I don't think there is. Nope. I think that's it. Alright, cool. Thank god. Holy shit. Finally, in Seamwood Island. Alright, I am going to be right back. I'm going to go get myself a cup of tea, and we'll be back. So, see ya in a little bit. Oh, okay, I'm back. Oh god, that's not great. Hold on a second. Okay. So... Pop up these. My channel showing up right now. I have no idea why that's also broken, but okay. So I'm back. I kinda have not really been playing this Pokemon, but I still want to stream it, so what I'm gonna do is I am going to open up my Super Nintendo emulator. I think I have some Super Nintendo games that will be good. And I'm just gonna look through it and see if we find and see how that goes. So, yeah, I think it'll be fun. I'll just have to save this. So, close that down. I also don't know how well it's going to fit. How is the music too loud? Hold on. Okay, that's maybe better. I was saying, yeah, sorry about that. I was saying that I don't really want to stream Pokemon anymore. I'm not really in the mood to play it, but I still want to play something. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up my Super Nintendo emulator, and I'm just going to look at what I have and then maybe just play some random Super Nintendo games and see how that goes. I think that'll be fun, just to kind of mess around and play some old Super Nintendo stuff. But real quick, I'm going to end the stream for a second and then start it back up so that I can, like I said, it's so that it's easier for me to export things separately if they're separated into different videos on my Twitch. So I'm going to quickly stop the stream and then start it back up immediately, and I'm going to play some Super Nintendo, so I will be right back.